Our next guest is going into the eye of the storm. He's going to Brazil December 20th. It was announced last week that this young Canadian man is going to Brazil to fight the former UFC bantamweight champion. Now, I was surprised because I thought Henan Barão was going to take some time off, but that is not the case. Henan Barão is coming back on December 20th, co-main event of the Lyoto Machida versus CB Dolloway card, and he'll be fighting the streaking Mitch Gagnon, Ontario's own Mitch Gagnon. He joins us right now on the MMA Hour. Mitch, how are you?
Pretty good, man. Just sitting in my car waiting to go training.
Oh no, are we keeping you? Are you late to training?
No, I'm early.
Okay, well that's Canadian for you. I mean, we're always very punctual, right?
Yeah.
By the way, I've always wanted to ask you this, and correct me if I'm wrong. I mean, of course, your name is a French name, Mitch Gagnon. Are you French Canadian?
I am. Yeah, I'm French Canadian.
So you're from that part of Ontario that's more French than English?
Well, you know, the North Ontario is pretty French.
Okay.
You split it right down the middle, really. You know, so yeah.
How much does it bother you when people call you like Gagnon or Gagnon? I mean, there's so many different variations of your name. How much does that bother you?
Doesn't bother me at all. most of my friends are English, so they always razzle me on the, you know, it's an ongoing thing for many years.
Okay, so let's talk about this opportunity. I mean, you've won four in a row. You've looked very good in the UFC, and you're not just fighting. I mean, most people thought, okay, you won four in a row now. You've looked solid. You're going to get a top 10 guy. You're not getting a top 10 guy. You're getting the former champ. And he was supposed to fight at 177. That didn't happen, of course. So he's just, you know, he's a fight removed from losing his belt. What was your reaction when you got the call that you'll be fighting Henan Barão in Brazil, of all places?
You know, I was shocked to even get the opportunity for a few reasons. Obviously, that I thought I was going to get it. Needed to get a few fights, you know, like top 10, but you know, high top 10. And number two was, you know, I thought Henan Barão was going to take some time off after, you know, his loss and then his bad cut, weight cut. You know, I thought he was going to take a step back and reevaluate things. But you know, I guess he's ready to go. And you know, I'm super happy, super excited for the opportunity.
Are you surprised that he's coming back? I mean, do you think it's a bit ill-advised? Because I thought the rematch was happening too soon, and we saw what happened there. I mean, his body essentially shut down on him. And now this fight is happening, you know, a little over 3 months later, and the body takes some trauma. He was beat up against TJ Dillashaw. He says he doesn't really remember most of the fight. So given all of that, are you surprised he's coming back in December?
Yeah, definitely. Very surprised, but, you know, at the end of the day, you know, I think they're a great camp. They know what they're doing, you know. So, it is what it is. If he thinks that he's ready to come back, you know, and they offer me the fight, I'm happy. I'm happy regardless.
Do you think that works to your advantage? Do you think that you're not going to see the best Henan Barão December 20th?
You know, I don't know. It could be the total opposite. It could be the best Henan Barão. I don't know. I'm not really focused on that. You know, I got 9 good weeks of preparing for this fight. You know, it's I'm not delusional. I know it's a big step up in competition, but you know, I've been pressing for this. I wanted this. Did I think I was going to get Henan Barão next? No, but you know, I'm happy. I'm really happy to really get this going, and then proving that, you know, probably 99% of the population are.
So you last fought just 16 days ago, so you're essentially getting no time off. Are you okay with that?
Yeah, you know what? I actually took 2 weeks off, though, you know, and that's good enough for me. I'm always in the gym working, and, you know, I'm healthy. I wanted 3 fights this year. That was one of the things I feel like I'm not doing enough is being active, so I'm pretty happy I got 3. I'll get 3 in there, and, you know, against the former champ, it's a cherry on the pie.
So you've had some visa issues in the past, and some people might not know this. This is going to be your first pro MMA fight outside of the great country of Canada. You're skipping the United States. You're skipping Europe. You're going straight to Brazil, which is obviously a very hot market for the UFC and very boisterous crowds, et cetera. And you're fighting, you know, one of their very own. Are you going to be able to go to Brazil? Because as I mentioned, you've had some visa issues in the past.
Yeah, you know, everything is settled. You know, my management and the UFC are working on that. And, you know, everything is settled on that end. And, you know, it's everything is good.
What were the problems?
You know, it's just something that happened, you know, over a decade ago. And, Really don't want to go into details, but you know, it's going to get resolved, and you know, I'm just focused on the fight.
So you're going to be able to fight in Brazil, U.S. No problems there, right?
No problem.
Well, that's good. I'm reassured now, because you know, remember in Chicago, like the week of the fight, you were turned back. That must have been devastating.
Very devastating. You know, I've worked, you know, put a lot of time in that camp, and not to fight, you know, it was heartbroken, especially being my debut fight.
You haven't been, I mean, you came back in April, but you had a pretty long, I mean, what was it?
Six months, I guess.
Seven months or so. Prior to that, you had a year off. Why have you not been as active as you would have liked?
A few injuries. You know, I blew out my knee between both September cards that I have fought on, and I actually, you know, I got injured a few times, and then, you know, obviously the visa issue, and so, you know, you put that the combination of my injuries and that, you know, that's why I haven't been active.
You said that 99% of people, or at least you feel that way, don't think that you're going to win. Why do you think that is? Is that simply because he's the former champ and they may not know you, or why do you feel like you're not getting the respect, at least early on here?
You know, you know, it's not what I think. It's what, you know, my Twitter feed got bombarded by the day that they announced the fight. So it's not really what I think. It's what I see. And,
right.
You know, at the end of the day, it you know, I'm too strong mentally and physically to really, that doesn't bother me at all.
So people were going to your Twitter feed and telling you that you're going to lose?
I'm like a lamb being fed to the wolves and
jeez,
yada, yada, yada. Well, yeah.
What kind of a person does that?
I guess Hannon Baralfa.
were these Brazilian people?
You know, like I said, I don't even look at it all. Like, I don't even finish reading the messages. If I see it's negative, it's not constructive for me. It's negative, and I just keep scrolling, you know. I see a good message, I'll retweet it.
do you just block these people right away? Because I recommend doing that if you don't.
You know, no, I guess, you know, how I see it is any publicity is good publicity. You could talk shit about me or talk great about me. It's, you know, it's part of the sport.
Have you talked to anyone? Go ahead.
Yeah. No, the more you advance in the sport, the more people will talk, you know, bad or negative. And, you know, it's one of those things that you just have to deal with and not, you know, bite into it emotionally. And just, it's part of the fight game.
I've been to Brazil a couple times. I've covered events there. I'm actually going there this weekend, and the crowds are second to none. I mean, they're very intimidating. If you're fighting, they chant, you know, you're going to die and all this stuff. Have you talked to any teammates or friends? I know the fight just was recently announced, but to try to get some kind of expectation as to what you're going to face there, because you are, I don't think I'm going out on a limb here. You are going to be, not the most liked man in Brazil when you fight there on December 20th.
Yeah, you know, I honestly didn't really put any thought into it. I'm just super excited for this fight. I've been, really just focused on getting back into training, having a good game plan for this fight, and you know, I'm really not focused on that right now.
Do you feel like if you beat Hannon Barão, you will be the number one contender?
Yeah, the division is really, really a little bit messed. You know, you got Dominic Cruz coming back, who's got a title shot against TJ Dillashaw. Then you get Ascensão, who's on a 7-fight streak, who's promised a fight against TJ. I don't know where that promise stands. I don't know. It's really not important for me right now. The importance right now is for me is the next 9 weeks getting prepared for Hannon Barão.
Well, I certainly think you'd have a strong case if you beat Hannon Barão. I'm wondering, will you watch the TJ Dillashaw fight a lot? I mean, that's one of the few losses on his record, of course. He went on this amazing streak. Will you try to replicate what TJ Dillashaw did?
You know, I'll let my coach decide, you know. Like, I have confidence in my coaches and whatever they feel like I should do. And, you know, I obviously have my little opinion on where I could win this fight, but... you know, I'll let my coach, you know, get the game plan going, and I'll just follow it.
Where do you think you can win this fight?
You know, I feel like if I put a lot of pressure on Hennin, I feel like I can make him do a lot of mistakes. And I think when he backs up, he's that's where he's more vulnerable. If you let him settle in and fight his fight, you know, you're going to be in a lot of trouble. I think if you move a lot and not being in the pocket with him and trade punches, you know, your chances are greater of winning this fight.
Will you watch the first fight? Will you watch that? I call it the first fight. The second one never happened. UFC 173, Dillashaw Burrell. Will you watch that fight as you prepare for this one?
Yeah, definitely. I already watched it a bunch of times before. I'm watching, you know, all his fights from then till, you know, all his fights I'm watching. You know, I want to see what he, you know, obviously fighters evolve, but there's some things that people keep doing, and you know, I want to see what he does always. And yeah, I'll definitely be watching his fights.
By the way, recently on this show, we were talking about the state of Canadian MMA, and I wasn't so high on it. I felt like not enough talent was coming out of Canada, perhaps because there aren't as many promotions building talent these days, and the UFC hasn't gone there, and GSP, you know, retired or at least walked away temporarily. What's your take on Canadian MMA today as opposed to a few years ago? Do you feel like it's in a good spot, or do you agree with me that there aren't as many prospects coming out of Canada these days?
You know, I wouldn't say prospect, but I do believe that we lack MMA shows to show that the talent we have. There's so much talent here, especially like where I train in Toronto. There's so much talent here, but there's not enough shows to get them fights, and it's slower for them to get fights. You know, I got a few buddies, they fight maybe once or twice a year, if that. And, you know, definitely MMA in Canada, or maybe like in Toronto area, Ontario, has down died.
Will you be doing your entire camp in Sudbury?
No, I haven't been doing my camps in Sudbury since my Caraway fight. I've been coming to Toronto, you know, pretty religiously to do my camps here.
Where in Toronto?
I move around a little bit. You know, I go to Ed Rush training facility where RG Grant is the head coach there, but for boxing. I go to Parabellum out of Oakville for my MMA specific stuff and kickboxing. I go see Joseph Valtellini, Bazooka Joe, Glory
yes.
Champ. I go see him religiously. And I move, yeah, it's probably those three gyms I mostly go out of. But I do, you know, various gyms on the odd time as well.
Are you going to have to go to Brazil for a media tour of sorts and, you know, take that all in and face off with them? This is a big fight. Are they going to do that for you?
Yeah, I think, I'm not sure the exact days, but, you know, I'm supposed to be flying out in the next couple of weeks anyways to do a media tour in Sao Paulo.
Oh, are you looking forward to this? Because you've never gotten that kind of attention before one of your fights, as far as the UFC is concerned. Are you looking forward to this?
For sure. Yeah, I'm riding it. I'm loving it. I'm enjoying every moment of it. I can't wait to be there and then just get through the process. It's going to be awesome.
All right. Well, I wish you the best of luck, Mitch. Thank you for coming on. December 20th, Hennin Burrell returns to action against Canada's own Mitch Gagnon, riding a 4-fight winning streak. He's looked very good as of late, and this is obviously a very big fight for both of them, for Hennin to try to get back on track and, of course, for Mitch to pick up the biggest win of his career. Wish you the best of luck. Good luck out there, Mitch, and thank you very much for the time. Great to have you on.
Thanks for having me.
All right. There he is, Mitch Gagnon, Ontario's own. So, you know, since I was crapping all over my home country as far as producing talent, in the last couple of weeks, Rory McDonald got a number one contender fight, and Mitch Gagnon's fighting Hennin Burrell very well may be a number one contender fight. So how about that? Perhaps I lit a fire under everyone. That's what I'd like to think.